Yes, hello. You've reached Hanging After Dark. You want to hear a song? All right, I'll have that right out. This one goes out to the lovebirds.
This is Hanging Heavy.
What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to a test run of a new segment that I'm thinking about starting. I don't know about you, but sometimes when love is in the air, you just can't deny it. And speaking of what's in the air, I smell some musk. I just can't bear. I'm talking about I'll Be His Bear Cub. I'm talking about Puppy Ray.
Oh, what's up, puppy?
But yeah, what do you think of that lovely new segment that I'm thinking about doing?
It's raw, you know.
Heavy after dark.
It's a rocks. It's just raw.
It's raw, uncut, and unfiltered.
Uncut, filtered.
Dude, remember seeing a DVD that said that, or not even a DVD, a VHS at a fucking rental place.
Yeah.
That you see that and you're like, oh, I gotta get it. Well, I mean, what if there's something awesome in all of this uncut and raw, unlabeled footage? It's always trash. Clickbait before clickbait. Fuck!
No shit, right?
Yeah.
That's how they get you.
Yeah. But yeah, before we get any further, we have a tradition around here. Puppy, I don't know if you're gonna take a shot, but.
No, I'm not going to take a shot.
Well, then, fuck it. I already poured it. So.
I'm going to take a shot of medicine.
Go ahead. Get some of that Tussum.
Mucinex. Not a sponsor.
Well, fuck it. I'm going to be the lonely alcoholic on today's episode. All right. 3, 2, 1, Rich and Rare. And it wasn't that bad.
Oof.
Yeah, it was fucking terrible. Fuck. Nothing a quick little chaser can't handle.
What the fuck?
That's how tight I am, puppy.
I know.
You want to hear again? What?
Sound like a cork.
Oh, it stopped doing the noise. No. I'm not tight anymore.
That Rich and Rare got you all loose.
Ooh. But yeah, hanging heavy, or what was it? Hanging heavy, heavy petting?
Heavy petting.
Hanging heavy petting? Hanging, or heavy after dark, with your lovemaker desecrator.
Ooh.
Surprise, motherfucker.
We're going to open request lines at 12.
Yeah, the lines will open up. Be one of the first callers and you'll get a free wet t-shirt.
Oh. A wet tanga.
And it's wet because I used it during the day.
Oh. We're buy a bulk of condoms we could just give away.
A bulk of condoms, yeah, for real. TLC style, baby. Damn, dude, we're boomers.
Yeah, we're old.
The yes, TLC sir. Reference. Woo-wee. Look at this guy.
That shit still exists, though?
What, being called a boomer?
Nah, like those late night requests, those love shits.
I don't know. I don't listen to the radio at all.
Yeah, I haven't listened to radio for like 5 years almost.
Dude, it's been longer than that for me.
Like, if I do, it's like the morning radio for like a quick second because I'm turning on the fucking...
Turning the car on.
Yeah.
Waiting for the Bluetooth connect and shit.
Yeah.
No, for me, it's when I'm changing CDs because I still use CDs like a fucking boomer. Hey, what the fuck? You don't laugh at that.
Do you try change CDs while you're driving?
I do, dude. I'm a boss at it.
Yeah, you have it down.
I've been doing it since the 90s, baby. I haven't been driving that long. I've been doing it since the 2000s. I've been doing it for 20 years, puppy. Goddamn.
Oh, shit. That's true.
Yeah, it was because... I mean, back when Bluetooth things started, like, it was terrible. The connection sucks. But now it's pretty fucking solid. I'd rather use Bluetooth than a fucking cord. But I'd rather use headphones than Bluetooth.
Remember that shit? The cassette thing?
Yeah, the adapters.
Yeah, fucking cassette.
And then they got all fancy with the iPod one that goes to the radio, with the radio station.
Oh, that's true. I remember that one.
And you just connect it onto the cigarette lighter with the iPod in it?
Yeah, that's true.
Speaking of that, they just discontinued iPods. Apparently, they were still making them, dude. Fuck.
What for?
For real, exactly, dude. They have, ever since the iPhone, there's no need for a fucking iPod, you idiot.
iPod. I guess they couldn't let it go, man.
I mean, if idiots are out there still buying them 30 years later, then yeah. I don't see why you wouldn't. Yeah, May 12th, the iPod as we know it is officially dead. On May 10th, Apple announced that it's quietly discontinuing the iPod Touch. Because the iPod Touch is essentially an iPhone with no service. They don't even have to make a different product, dude. Look how easy Macintosh or Apple has had it. Damn it, dude, I'm a boomer. Fuck, dude. There's no way around it, man.
I only bought two. I never had the big iPod. I only had the mini.
The mini is which one? Is that the one that's like really fat? But no. It's narrow?
Yeah, it was slim, I guess. I had the slim one. It was black. It was real black. Is it mini?
Okay, so, yeah, the mini. The mini is... You can put these with SD cards now. So they can hold up to essentially a terabyte worth of music. And they're supposedly really easy to fix. And if... you need any parts, there's like people making custom parts for these, so like it's really easy to mod one with a bigger battery and a flash storage.
I've
been wanting to buy one forever, but since the iPod mini, the second generation, is the one that they say works the easiest, they're getting hard to find and expensive.
I had one of these. I had two of them. I gave one to my nephew or some shit, and I bought one for myself.
I want one of these, dude. Just to do that, right? Because I hate having my phone connected, and then, like, if you don't want to have the fucking phone ringing or whatever, the music uninterrupted when you leave or whatever, to me, it's so much easier just to have another fucking device just for music.
Well, how people keep buying them.
Yeah. I should have bought one when I had the... I mean, they're pretty cheap right now. They're going for, what, $40?
Yeah.
But some of them are expensive. Some of them... Some people even sell them, like, already modded. And I might just buy one of those. Because I never had an iPod, ever. I had a Zune.
A Zune? You had the Sony? Is that the Sony?
No, the Zune was the one from Windows.
Oh, window. Oh.
I bought it when we were working at that place. Because they had them on sale, and then I think you got a discount because they had some partnership with the place we were working or some shit. I got it dirt cheap, dude.
Oh, shit.
And I used it every day that I went to work there, so, I mean, it worked out. And I loved using it, dude. It was some... People shit on Zune for it being terrible, but that one worked fucking flawless for me. I never had any issues with it. I guess I'm just not an idiot. It doesn't have a click wheel, but it had like a touchpad, and it was just as good. I don't know.
I just never got it because I had the iPod.
Yeah, well, like, what the fuck's the point?
Yeah, I'm not. Man, they're
I'm not gonna buy two. Yeah.
Yeah.
What is it called? I had that little one. Oh, it was just called the Zune, the 8 gig. But the reason why mine was cheap, I remember it was brown.
It was caca brown.
Yeah, it was brown. Dude, nobody wanted that one, apparently. I think I bought it for like $80 back then. It's going for 40 now, and this is like 20 years later. I didn't know, though. These things apparently had Wi-Fi and shit on them, so you could use them over the internet.
What?
I don't know why you would want to do that. But, dude, using Windows to drag and drop music is so much easier than iTunes. Fuck iTunes.
Yeah, it was a little bit of a hassle.
It's not that it's a hassle. It's just that you got to go through, like, three different steps when on Windows all you got to do is highlight everything and drag it over. One was way easier, I guess. But, I mean, Windows had been using MP3 way longer than Apple at the time. MP3 players had been out forever since that. At that point.
Yeah, I remember.
I think they started coming out in like the 80s or the early 90s.
Yeah, but even if it like one song.
Yeah, it was like 8 megabytes of storage. You could listen to...
Yeah, you just heard the intro.
Yeah, this is all you heard. Hold on. Let me change the song. That wasn't it. No. Yeah, that one. 20 different fucking memory cards. Yeah, dude.
Look how far we've come.
I know. There's a channel on YouTube, and this is what got me into wanting to redo my own iPod. His YouTube channel is called Dank Pods, and he's from Australia. And I started watching those videos because he was modding iPods. And I was like, wow, I've never known that was a thing. That's cool. Let me see what the fuck this is. And then I fell in love with his character. He's funny. Aww. Australian people. Dude, his video is the first one that comes out here. I Googled Zune Mini. And his video is the one that pops up on the videos. And it's, I bought a Zune in 2020. Dank Pods. Pretty funny, dude. Entertaining quality content from that guy. And because he's Australian, it's funnier. I don't know why, but that's just how my brain works. I think Australian people sound funny. I'm a dumb American. Whoops. Closed my window, but... Anyway, speaking about getting into the system, puppy, you were telling me you saw a fucking sweet movie.
Oh, I did.
That goes on forever, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. I'm like, when? Okay.
Yeah, but we gotta watch the movie. Yeah, we're gonna watch all of it right now.
All four fucking films.
So why don't you go ahead and announce what you saw, puppy?
I saw The Matrix Resurrections. That shit has stayed dead.
Surprise, motherfucker. God damn it, Bobby.
Have you seen all of them? All three of them?
I saw the first one and maybe the second one.
Wait, I haven't seen the third one.
Which one is the third one? Is that the one with the two white dudes that are like viruses or some shit?
I think that's the second one. That's the second one.
The third one is the one where they use too much CGI then.
Yeah.
I never watched that one. Yeah, I don't think I even saw the second one then. Fuck.
I think they fight for like a whole hour, him and Smith.
Yeah, I was watching a video today, of this dude is talking about why he thinks modern movies are trash. And the topic of this segment was overuse of CGI, and the Matrix one was on it. So that's funny that you bring it up today. And I really like his movie reviews. They're pretty accurate to my personal taste. And fucking, he talked about the new one, and he, like, just from the trailer, he was like, "This ain't it, Chief."
Yeah, because compared to the first Matrix, yes, they used CGI, but it wasn't
overused.
Yeah, it wasn't. Like, it was still Neo doing the bullet time shit.
Well, I mean, just,
or Keanu, whatever. You're still them walking on the walls trying to do all that shit.
Yeah, yeah, they were using a lot of wire work.
Yeah, that's understandable, right? But
yeah, that it's still physical, right?
Yeah, but I remember when the second one came out and him and the 100 agents came out.
Oh yeah, that's when they like all pile up on him and it looks fucking stupid.
Yeah, all CGI everything. It wasn't them, but like when. Well, we should have had them fighting, right? Like, I don't know.
Yeah, well, they fight in the first one all badass.
Yeah, exactly. If old boy did it.
Well, maybe that's why, because he got too old.
I don't know. Whatever, right? But yeah, the Resurrections.
And this is coming from you, and your opinion of Keanu is he can do no wrong.
He could never do no wrong. I blame the director and Trinity. Fucking play.
You heard it here, folks.
I don't know whose idea was this, but yeah.
The Wachowskis?
Yeah. Well, I think it's just one of them.
Whatever. I'm not going to try to fucking... I'm not stepping on that mine, puppy.
I guess I am.
I ain't going there. Take it easy, Bruno Mars. I'll get you grenade for you.
I guess he'll protect me then, puppy.
The chosen one?
No.
Okay, so I think I know a little bit. He's no longer the chosen one, right? Now they're the chosen two or whatever?
It's
so stupid.
Yeah, it's like, you know what? Let's redo it.
Let's just completely undo everything that we spent the last 15 years doing. Because isn't the animated series pretty good?
Oh yeah, the anime series is actually like where it shows a prequel. It fills in like a little gap between the two movies. It does like all the stories.
Yeah, like it helps with the canon.
Yeah, this one they're like, you know what?
Forget
all that. I didn't like how it ended. Let's rearrange the ending some way, somehow.
Let's do the real ending. Wink, wink.
Yeah, because you know. Because the way society is nowadays, what their fucking reason was, but it was stupid, man. Apparently Keanu is back in the Matrix and he is a video game
He's a video game developer or some dumb shit.
And the game he developed and made him so much money and famous was the Matrix.
Yeah, of course. So when he was, hold on, was he like hold on. Fuck! I don't have another... Never mind. That's because I don't want to type. Okay, watch. Was he like this? Whoa. Morpheus? No. Was that how it went?
Yeah. Trinity. Oh.
Yeah.
But... Not even that, they changed Morpheus. Obviously, Morpheus died. I mean, you guys played the game. He died. So.
What? Oh, no!
God damn it, Bobby.
But anyways, like, they brought him back as a program. And he's not, like, Morpheus.
He's, like, the Asian chick?
No, Morpheus.
He's the skinny young black dude now, right?
Yeah, but he has, like... I don't know, pizzazz, I guess. Shit, I don't know.
Pizzazz? He's got to zazz it up.
Yeah, he does. He's like, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know how to describe it right now.
Hold on, was it like pizzazz?
Look at the cover of the Matrix poster where all of them in there. You see the black guy wearing a pink.
You mean flamboyant?
A little bit. But not like that. It's not obviously it's not Morpheus because it's a program, so he's acting different. I guess, whatever. And they brought back also Agent Smith. He also is different. It's not like Agent Smith. He's
wearing a pink. He's wearing a red suit. Take it easy, dude.
Whatever. Red, pink, orange. I don't care.
It's more of a burgundy puppy.
Whatever.
Oh, but I see. There's a clip where he's wearing a yellow suit.
Yeah.
Yikers.
Yeah, and then Agent Smith is some white, like, I don't know, like this FBI agent with character. I don't know. It's hard to describe, dude. I don't know, you gotta see it. I can't describe it right now.
Never gonna see this.
Yeah, you're not gonna see it. It's not like. I don't know what the fuck they try to do, dude. They just try to redo the ending and they fucked it up. Pretty much. I'm sorry. I'm not describing this fucking movie. Because, you know what? Don't watch this fucking movie.
Because this movie sucks.
It did, man. I was like, at the end, they fly away together. Fuck, spoilers, right?
Papi, why would you do that to me?
Because, like, they didn't even redo the song. They some shitty ass band cover, Raging as a Machine. And they both fucking fly away because they both are the ones. Because
they're both the chosen one?
Yes, I'm like, no, why did you guys do this?
Oh, in the deleted scenes, he flies away and he accidentally drops. What's her name? The chick. Fuck, I can't remember.
Trinity?
He accidentally drops her and she dies. Because she wasn't chosen. That was an alternate ending, puppy. You didn't stay after the credits.
No, I didn't.
I was out before they were even finished. I was gone before the credits.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I was like, no, why? Well, what happened? Like, I know, like, a lot of people weren't fan of the other two, the last two. I was like, I understand why people didn't like the other two, but I still kind of liked it. I was like, eh, it's not bad, whatever. But this one, yeah, fuck this shit. I don't know, man. It was a piece of shit movie, man.
Tell me how you really feel, puppy. Fuck.
Dude, if I wasn't a fan of The Matrix and I was still holding on to, like, it's gonna change, right? It's gonna get better.
Didn't I say that the last time? I was like, I stayed there, like, it's gonna get better at the end.
Exactly. I was like, it's gonna get better, right? It's gonna get
better. There's 15 more minutes. Something awesome's gonna happen.
Yeah. Laurie Fishburne's gonna come out and beat the shit out of everybody, and then
he's gonna come out, but he's gonna be the dude from Pee Wee's Playhouse.
You know, the cowboy what? Earl or some shit?
I don't remember the name. Fuck.
I don't know. Like, shit. I don't know. But then I was like, nope. I look like the movie's indie, and yeah,
Cowboy Curtis.
Curtis, there you go. That was close, though. Yeah.
So, if you were to rate it 1 out of 10,
0, I guess 0. So
1 from 1 to 10, no 0. It's not a thing. From 1 to 10. 1 being ask for your money back, and 10 being greatest movie I've ever seen. I'm going to name my child after the main character.
It's a 1, man. I mean, the only reason you want to keep seeing it is the action. It's decent, but it's not a lot of it, you know?
Well, Keanu's already like 80 years old.
Yeah, it's the people are doing the more of the fighting.
Of course.
Cattle just does the force field and like a stops the bullets and does like those push, you know, that invisible push.
The chi force?
Yeah.
That's so
guess he's fucking
wait, old. Hold on, puppy, did he have the 10 rings?
No, he didn't. Oh, maybe he had them somewhere we couldn't see.
This is Keanu in the 10 cock ring chi.
I mean, I love Keanu, man, but shit, man. He could say something, Keanu.
You have a little more say-so in this.
Yeah, because this movie should have been part of Keanu Day. Remember, like, 2 years ago? Because this movie was going to come out with John Wick, and it was going to be Keanu Day and shit. Well, I guess thank God for that. That shit didn't happen.
Yeah, they canceled it.
Yeah, fuck that movie, man. It just, it was, they shit on the Matrix on that one. I don't know. They should have just either made a whole new story. Or do a prequel. Fuck, you know, everybody's doing fucking prequels and whatnot. But don't continue just to rewrite the ending.
Yeah, they could have done like the Matrix Trinity Reborn or whatever the fuck, you know.
And continue, yeah, make her
own story. Yeah, make her own movie. Fuck.
Yeah. Because not only that, half of the movies they spent telling you what happened in the other movies, first movie. Like, they're recapping you. I'm like, why are you recapping me? I don't know what the fuck I'm watching. I don't know. I think it was stupid.
Did it leave you with a big fat boner?
No, it left me with like my ass sore.
Can you say that one more time?
I left my ass was sore.
Yeah, well, see, now you know how I feel about
cop out or what?
No, the strong women thing. I think we talked about it last time. Like when they force it, and it doesn't make sense. Make any sense. Why?
But Trinity was already a strong woman.
Yeah, she was a strong woman. Exactly. Like, why do they got to make her even stronger? Now she's the one. Like, what the fuck, dude? She was strong in her own right. She was willing to sacrifice herself.
You know what? I hate it too. Like, remember the both in all of them, how they were afraid of the agents.
Yeah.
Like, they were fucking terrified. They're like, fuck, we're gonna die. And they didn't have this. Like, there was no urgency like that.
Now they were, well, because they were OP.
No, but not because Keanu and Trinity. I'm talking about the other people.
Yeah, it was because they're OP, dude. They're strong, diverse people.
Yeah, you're right.
I hate when that shit ruins movies, dude. Speaking of that, they say that's the reason why Top Gun is so fucking good. People really love this new Top Gun.
Yeah, my coworker was telling me that's fucking awesome. I'm like, oh, okay.
I've never seen the first one.
Really? It's on Netflix or shit.
I mean, I only wanted to watch it in the volleyball scene, let's be real.
Oh.
I mean, that's the only thing I remember. I'm pretty sure I've seen it, but I just remember that. And
the Val Kilmer bite.
Mm-hmm. Wow, those are the only two things I remember. Mm.
Keep Val Kilmer. I think they were able to put him in.
Yeah, he comes out in it, and apparently he's going to be doing some other movies now, too.
Did they CGI him in?
No, he was there, and I think he even talked a little bit. I've never seen it, though, so I don't know. It's just from what I've heard.
Yeah, I heard that, too, but I know a picture came out of him, but I hope it wasn't just a picture.
It was like a cardboard cutout.
Because, you know, he has cancer.
Right? Oh, yeah, he has some kind of throat cancer or some shit.
Yeah, he fucking talks to the...
He can't talk.
Yeah,
whatever. He needs that little fucking... ing.
And I love that cover. Love that bite. Hey, man, he was... what was he? Fucking Tombstone.
Yeah.
I forgot his name.
Butch Cassidy?
No, that Butch Cassidy.
Billy the Kid?
No.
Dude, he's been...
Doc Holliday.
Holliday, god damn it. Isn't he Billy the Kid in another movie?
No, though? I'll be a Huckleberry.
Let me see. Yeah, he's Billy the Kid, you fuck.
When?
In 1989, puppy. He comes out in the movie Billy the Kid. Oh, okay. As Billy the Kid.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
And he's also in Young Guns.
He comes on Young Guns?
I think in the second one. I may be wrong.
Regulators!
No, he doesn't. No. I'm thinking of Kiefer.
That's Emilio Estevez.
Emilio!
He's Billy the Kid there.
Emilio! Dude, that guy was cute as fuck when he was young, huh?
Who, Emilio?
Emilio, right? Yeah.
He could coach me anytime.
I'll be on his Pee Wee team any time of the week.
Oh, he could
Show I'll take all the shots in the net.
Show me how to grab my hockey stick.
He can show me how to stick handle. I wait, wrong button.
Now we're gonna get canceled now.
Yeah, it's alright. If we didn't get canceled, or if I didn't get canceled after the last episode, it's not gonna happen.
The Matrix is gonna cancel.
Oh, now. We're gonna get lost in the Matrix now.
Oh.
Come on, do it.
Who is your daddy, and what does he do?
Yeah, I didn't. There's no point bringing back Morpheus and Agent Smith. And
when you finished watching it, were you like,
Jesus, Marge, what the fuck?
Pretty much. I just walked off. I was like, mad. I was like, fuck, I wanted to punch
it's
something.
It's not a tumor.
I should have punched the person in the concession stand. Just punch him.
Idiot.
Today ain't your day. Unforgivable.
Fucking Keanu.
Whoa.
He probably went there when he finished watching the film. Like, whoa.
Did you ever watch the Bill and Ted?
I wanted to.
I wanted to too, but dude, at the same time, you don't want to see your heroes like that, you know?
At this point, I guess I should. I already ruined this fucking shitty ass film.
Yeah, well, you ruined the mystique with watching that one.
Surprise, motherfucker.
I thought when I saw Ronin 47 was bad, but.
Ronin 47? I never saw that one.
It wasn't that great, but I was like, it wasn't bad. You know, like, it's a solo movie, whatever. You know, everybody has a shitty movie, but when you do a franchise, like, even worse, like, come on, man.
You blew it!
Everybody here is trying to resurrect franchises. This guy resurrected to kill it even more.
This guy resurrected it to bury it in the ground?
Yes. Okay, I guess that's enough of the Matrix.
Not a smart man.
Dude, I have a perfect button.
He should overdose on those fucking pills. God, I'm...
Oof. Okay, puppy. The other day I was watching TV and I saw something that I was like, this has to be a button for anything that sucks.
Whoa. I think I just figured something out, Beavis. What? This sucks. It really sucks. This sucks more than anything that has ever sucked before.
Oh, man, I used to love Beavis and Butthead. That shit was awesome.
Weren't you going to bring it back?
They did. For a little bit, I think. Maybe a season or two.
It did. It didn't work out.
It didn't stick. Nah, I don't think it did.
Nah, it's different times, though.
Yeah. Beavis and Butthead would not fly.
Yeah, I used to watch it.
He was a-working in my camper. Who was out there a-whacking it? Why would they always fuck with that guy?
I don't know. It was a neighbor, no?
I think so. Or he lived down the street from them.
I guess. The only person they could pick on because everybody will beat the shit out of
him. Yeah, everyone else would beat their ass.
Yeah.
Did you ever play the video game?
I don't know if I did, man.
It was for SNES. NES, fuck. SNES, Jesus
Christ. SNES, yes. SNES. I know. I don't think I did. I can't remember.
Like, it was pretty hard. Dude, but there's a weapon that you can get. It's a baseball bat with a glove on the end of it. A boxing glove. No, it was the fucking OP weapon. Oh,
was it like a side scroller?
Kind of like a, not a side scroller, but sort of. Kind of like a beat 'em up, also. A beat 'em up adventure, I guess.
Like a Castlevania Double Dragon kind of shit.
Kind of like a Streets of Rage. Or the Ninja Turtles one.
Oh, okay.
Where, like, you gotta clear an area and then move on kind of deal. That would be a pretty fun game to fucking play. We should, you should get a new PC, puppy. I play it on PC. Fucking 30-year-old game. Buy a PC to play games that were 30 years old. I already did it, so. Let me see him, but, man.
Beavis and Butthead, yeah. That's it. We are boomers.
We are, dude. Big time. Fucking game, dude. Fuck. Oh, it was also for the Genesis. No way.
Oh, I had the Genesis. I think I still
I had
it.
A Genesis. I didn't have a Super Nintendo. Look, oh, I'll wait. No, buy- you know what? I did get a Super Nintendo afterwards.
I'll just buy it for the Genesis. We'll play it. Here in the couch. Oh,
we should stream it. I would stream that game. Even if nobody watches. Fuck. Who's playing Beavis and Butthead right now? Let me see if there's anybody on Twitch doing that.
No one.
Because Hanging Heavy has a Twitch channel, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, do we?
Oh, we do. Never used it. I went live once. Just to test it.
Hanging Heavy, the video game edition. Playing 30-year-old games.
For real.
Because we don't know any better.
Okay, so everything that I see here, somebody did a review, okay? From what I've seen here, people are doing... I guess... these are at 3 years old is the youngest one. People are doing playthroughs. I've only found two playthroughs of it, and it was for the Game Boy, so it's not even the same thing. Nerd.
Game Boy. What the fuck?
Yeah. Beavis and Butthead Game Boy Part 1 of 2. What a strange game. But I would love to play this. Let me see. Can you find it on Amazon? You can, dude, for Genesis. How much? How much? How much? $35? Get the fuck out of here. Whoa. Oh, here's one. $20. Sega Mega Drive for Genesis.
Sega Mega Drive?
It's just the name of the cartridge. It's a, one of the bigger ones, not like the small.
No, the yellow thing on the side?
No, not that one. It's the one that has a little notch in it. Because it's hard to describe. Just look it up. Here, watch. Now that we found the... Bang. Was that you?
What?
Did you put something in? Oh, whatever.
Me? No, that was you. Right, yeah, oh, yeah. Okay, I see. Oh, yeah.
$20. Because they have the normal one on the bottom, but it's a reproduction. They want $30 for it. Get the fuck out of here. Oh, there's a $20 one with a box. With a box. Oh, $35. Fuck you, bro.
The box. It's in the box.
What's in the box? The dude, remember when games used to fucking be something? Like, now you... Like, for the Switch, a lot of the times the games don't even come with a game. It's just, like, a code inside the game box.
What the fuck you do with the code? You download the game?
You download the game, yeah.
What?
Exactly, dude. What the fuck? And then when you do buy them, they're, like, little memory cards. You don't even need the box for that.
I remember when they came out, they were telling people not to taste it or eat it.
No, they have a chemical that they put on them that they're covered in like some kind of bitter shit. So kids don't eat them.
Jesus.
It's smart. I don't know what that chemical would do to you in the long run, but it's supposed to be super bitter to get kids to spit them out so they don't swallow them. Because luckily, I didn't have to go through it, but my kid, when he was little, he didn't put shit in his mouth. And now he's kind of a germaphobe, and that's a whole different kind of worms. But no, he just doesn't like to get dirty.
Right? What's wrong with that?
I mean, to me, there's something wrong with that. Like, you're a kid. Go fucking fall in the dirt and get up and just dust yourself off. Like, he'd rather not even just go outside. Come on, man.
Some people are meant not to go outside, man.
I mean, we live in Texas, dude, and it's hot as fuck, so I don't blame him. But that sucks. Like, kids aren't kids like they used to be, you know?
Yeah, I was gonna say that. It's not like... It's very common now.
Yeah. Yeah. That sucks.
But man, I used to play outside without shoes.
Yeah.
I used to just fucking have callus in my fucking feet and shit.
Your fucking caveman ass feet.
Not like, because my parents couldn't afford it. I was just fucking lazy to put shoes on, and I was just like, I was outside.
Yeah, why? You're going to be like, oh, I've finished my homework. Just running.
And that's all I have to say about that.
Just ask Madball. He'll remember, like, how come you don't shoot? Because
you know how long that would take?
Yeah, to find socks.
To find socks? Yeah, fuck.
Have you seen my room?
I don't know which ones are clean anymore.
No, I don't.
I mean, let's be honest, none of them were clean. Whoopsie! And not the one from under the bed.
Woo! It's a play basketball in my backyard, because I had, like, a little court. So we just play basketball in my backyard. I wouldn't put my shoes on.
You're in your backyard. Why would you?
Yeah.
But, like, you said, fucking savage.
I would get callus and like, what do you call it? Blisters also. Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
I'm not a smart man.
No, I'm not.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Blisters from being barefoot, puppy. dude, you're such a fucking Mexican.
Man, I had a neighbor who always wore sandals, man. I don't know how the fuck he would play in sandals.
Yeah, I hate walking when... just when it's wet. Sandals suck. And then, like, just your feet sweating? They're gonna sweat.
Man, he had these sports sandals, so...
Oh, they had moisture-wicking technology?
Yeah, like, it, like they were, like, slip-ons. I don't know, they were weird, but they were, like... they wouldn't fall off if you ran with them, I guess.
Are they the ones that have, like, the ankle strap or whatever?
Yeah, somewhat ankle strap with like, the middle of your foot also wrapped so your toes are exposed and shit.
The ones that look like a harness.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about. Fuck, what are those called?
I don't know. Fuck, they're sandals because they're kind of like
sandals. Yeah, they're sandals, yeah.
I don't know how you call them. Maybe they had a name.
They're called harness sandals.
Oh. Hey, man, we just be playing basketball. You hear that? The fucking clack, 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 clack.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. That's so stupid. They're called harness sandals. The ones that look like a harness. Yeah, you fuck.
And they were like, dude, you don't have tennis shoes?
Dude, these are sick, though. I want these. I hate sandals, but, dude, these look like... These are fucking... These are 90s sandals for sure. Check the chat. Dude.
What the fuck?
Dude, they have a whole bunch of different ones. They have some pretty sick ones.
And they have the colors of the 90s, too.
Yeah, that's why. They even have 80 ones. Dude, they have some checkered ones that are pretty sick. Oh, dude, these are sick! These are definitely 90s shoes. I might get a pair. Fuck. $50 though? You know what's funny? These are Teva, not a sponsor.
And that's all I have to say about that.
But I used to work at an outdoor store that went out of business. And I took a couple of things while they were getting rid of crap. And one of them was a Teva display. And what this display is essentially like a pegboard holder. So eventually I'm going to put all of my audio equipment hanging on it, on pegs. But that's funny that we're looking at Teva shoes and I have a Teva display in right behind me.
Fucking harness scent. But yeah, man, I just...
Camel Sports, that's the name of the other ones. Not a sponsor.
I don't know how you're able to run with these fucking shits.
I don't know. It's like having just a strip of leather under your foot.
I guess, shit. He was all Romans and shit.
Yeah, that's all Roman fucking gladiator shit. Excuse me. Goddamn Spartan.
I'll tell you one thing. This kid who wore sandals, like, we'll play, bringing kids playing, we'll play all, every sport during whatever season it was.
Yeah.
Man, he could run the cleanest route for a receiver. Like,
in sandals?
In sandals. Like, shut, he didn't play sports in,
like, in school?
In school. I don't know why. He was younger than me. He was like 3 years younger than me.
But he was a good wideout.
He could have played receiver for middle school and high school.
Yeah, at least for high school, yeah.
He ran it good, but the problem was
he couldn't catch.
He couldn't catch.
Man, well, he could have been a receiver then, or a running back.
No, a corner maybe.
Oh yeah, a corner. Yeah. All he has to do is push the ball away.
Yeah, because he's not gonna catch it. Or either
he doesn't have to catch it. Yeah. Catching it is just extra. Yeah.
Yeah. Man, but he was able to, like, man, he ran the routes nice. Like, wow. And I would throw him the ball, or the person who was quarterback for us would throw him the ball, and yeah, I would drop it
every time.
I would say 60%
drops.
Drops.
Oh, that guy would never have a job.
Yeah. I'll tell you this one time. It happened happened twice. But the first time when it happened, it was fucking hilarious. Like, he ran like a goal route, but he didn't just went straight. He faked out the guy,
mm-hmm.
and then ran straight. And I didn't throw him the ball. I think somebody else threw him the ball. And it was perfect. Like, everything was perfect. And the ball went straight to his hands. It went, like, everything was so perfect that he didn't catch the ball. It just went straight through his hands. When the ball hit the ground, it literally bounced back straight up and hit him in the face.
Oh, I was going to say, did you doink it off of him? But no, that's even worse.
It's even worse, man. It fucking
bounced, like, off the ground and hit him. Imagine right in the face.
Hit him in the face, back into his face. Or like,
while he's running towards it?
Yes.
That's like a fucking punch in the mouth.
Yeah, like, what the fuck, kid? But, like, you know, whatever. But yes, that when it happened, we couldn't believe it. And we were just all laughing, you know. See, he was sad. He, you know.
I'll wait though.
But we're like, don't worry, kid. Like, don't worry, man.
He was because like, fuck that.
Because he was part of my team. My because we used to play against other kids from around the neighborhood. Like, you know, we laugh, but we're like, we can't laugh too hard because
he's on our side.
He's in our team, right? Yeah. We can't have him like that for the rest of the game.
Yeah. You gotta hit him back up, dude. You gotta pick him up when they fall down.
Let that. Come back, man. It's good. It's all good.
We got another one. We're gonna try again.
Yeah, we'll try again. Wait. You'll catch the next one. Next week you'll catch.
Just make sure your hands are dry. Did he grab it or did he just? Like if he's trying to pick up a watermelon and it just,
yeah,
it right just between
right between his hands.
He didn't close his hands.
Yeah. And hit him back in his face. I was like, I think I never seen that in my life. I was like, what the fuck did I just see? And no, it's just shocking or surprise and fucking funny as fuck. I was like, what the fuck? Oh, yeah. Poor kid. Fucking chanclas. It was a chanclas. I blame
it was the chanclas. Yeah, maybe. You know how sometimes when you're running with sandals and the front gets caught when you're dragging your foot, that sound it makes, whack, whack, slaps the fuck out of the bottom of your foot. fuck, dude. Chihuahuas. Shout out to Huarache.
Run the cleanest route, man. They just couldn't catch.
You should have got some stick'em.
We didn't know that back then.
Come on, puppy. You're a Niners fan, puppy. You knew all about that.
I would quit for it.
Just get cheek, Larry.
Get cheek.
Hey, why does he have bubble gum on his hands? Nah, he has alopecia. Or what is that, a skin condition? Not alopecia, that's bald. That's being bald.
He has dry hands.
He has dry hands. He needs cream.
He needs cream.
Vitiligo. Okay, that's what it is. Vitiligo. Alright. Alopecia. Close enough. You know what I meant. Oh, excuse me, I'm sorry.
1, 2, 3, 5, 6,
cha-cha, bitch. Aye. Aye. 5, 6, cha-cha, bitch. AB, shout out. Adelante. Garbage. Are you the Monte? Garbage. Adelante. Dude, I wish we had those. We need to get walkie-talkies.
So we could play the games without using the voice chat.
No, so we could just fuck around. Like, have them on all the time. And just hear, fuck you. Or...
You want to go halfies?
No.
No, you don't want them.
Let's see how much they cost. How many mile radius do you think we would need? 20 miles?
There's one for 28 for $50. Hey, you live dirty for the discount?
Oh, yeah, it's at the place or what?
Yeah.
Let's see there. Hey, that's actually not a bad idea. If it comes in a bundle of four, we can give them one.
There's only two.
I was going to say we could get one for garbage, but how far would he have to be?
That's fucking far. That's...
38 mile right here. 79, yeah. 28 mile, 49. 35 mile. Two way. Dude, nothing comes with more than one. Three. 24 and a half.
There's three one with 28 miles.
There's three right here with 30 miles. 112. This is the dumbest thing. We have phones.
I know.
You know what? Actually, there's a... actually, a good one. There's an app that I have with my kid. And it's essentially a walkie-talkie app. Since he doesn't have a phone, I put it on his iPad. So if like I'm outside and I need to call him, I'll be like, hey, come outside real quick. So that's pretty cool. And it's free. It's called Zello. Not a sponsor.
It's always on or what?
You can have it always on, but like for me, as soon as I close it, it turns off. If you don't exit it, it stays on. But if you exit it, it turns off. So, like, if I needed to send you a message, I'd have to turn it on first. I mean, if you download it right now, we can fuck with it. Poppy. Well, if you want, Poppy, we're like 5 minutes away from the very... Or 5 minutes away from an hour. And you're starting to sound worse and worse, Poppy. So yes, one more time. Let's have it for all of our lovers, our lover boys and lover girls from all around the world. Hanging after dark. Mm-hmm. No, heavy after dark. Just let you. Yeah.
Come on!
Who is your daddy?
It's not just garbage though. Carlton is also on a mission, let's say. So we got our boys in the field. Hopefully they make it out alive.
Come on. Do it. Come on.
Chinga. This concludes the Love and Heavy.
Whoopsie! Hold on. Fuck. No! This concludes Love and Heavy. Nice. But yeah, fucking, we finally got some new albums to criticize, and by that I mean we're gonna do your mom pretty soon.
Whoopsie! Oh yeah! Woo!
And by your mom, I mean your music of the month. It was a segment that we haven't done in quite a while. And I recently picked up 9 new albums, so we have even more trash to go through.
And that's all I have to say about that.
But yeah, hopefully everyone is doing well. Shit's really starting to go down. But yeah, hopefully everyone's in a good headspace and everyone's healthy, and we'll get through this. Because now that we found... but yeah, fucking... We appreciate everyone that listens to Hanging Heavy, even if you're just a bot.
He'd be like, shut the fuck up.
But yeah. I'm your boy, Desecrator. This has been Hanging Heavy. Hopefully, our boys... across enemy lines, we're able to penetrate the forces. But find out next time on Hanging Heavy.
This is Hanging Heavy.